Good afternoon. Welcome to Celebration Weekend. I'm Paul Arch, parish representative for this year's annual appeal. Today we're celebrating the good work being done throughout the Scranton Diocese. Thanks to your generous support, we are helping the most vulnerable individuals in the community, showing the good news of Christ and living our Catholic faith. We'll be showing a short video featuring some of the ministries that are funded by the appeal. Our parish goal is $34,000, and many parishioners have already made their pledge to the tune of approximately $13,000. If you have not already made your pledge, please feel free to begin filling out the envelopes that are placed in the pews. They can be put in today's collection basket, mailed directly to the diocese, or returned in a future basket. And remember that most gifts are less than $100, so we're asking that you pledge only what you can afford. Thank you, and God bless.
Good evening. Welcome to the parish community of St. Robert Bellarmine. Today's modern culture can often make it difficult for us to be persistent in the things we do. We are conditioned to get information and solutions to our problems instantaneously. Prayer, however, is seldom instantaneous. Let us strive to remain persistent in our prayer as we lift our hearts and needs to God in this liturgy. Our gathering hymn is, O God, our help in ages past, which can be found in the We Celebrate hymnal, number 872. Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Let us acknowledge our sins us to new life in the Spirit, Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ, have mercy. You come with salvation for your people, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in highest, and on earth peace to the people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to and serve your majesty and sincerity of heart through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, Amalek came and waged war against Israel. Moses therefore said to Joshua, "Pick out certain men, and tomorrow go and engage Amalek in battle. I will be standing on top of the hill with the staff of God in my hand." So Joshua did as Moses told him. He engaged Amalek in battle. After Moses had climbed to the top of the hill with Aaron and Hur. As long as Moses kept his hands raised up, Israel had the better of the fight. But when he let his hands rest, Amalek had the better of the fight. Moses' hands, however, grew tired, so they put a rock in place for him to sit on. Meanwhile, Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and one on the other, so that his hands remained steady till sunset. And Joshua mowed down Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing the responsorial psalm, which can be found on page 70 of the Missalette.
Oh,
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know from whom you learned it, and that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingdom power. Proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Next May, and so
The message is on vocations. There's another one on education. There's another one on NCYC. There's another one on Catholic social services and so forth. So we'll pay attention on vocations because we do need priests in the diocese. So let's watch that one. Once we get it up. That's a big team. It's about an 86 inch. We're going to get that in a moment. That's a beautiful base. Well, guess what? The message is, the bishop, of course, you know this goes on every year, the annual appeal, and we made a goal every year. We went over the goal. Our goal here is 30-some thousand, 34,000. Last year we went over the goal, $1,000-some dollars. Exaltation, those of you here, Exaltation last year, we went over the goal, $13,000. So you've been doing your part every year in supporting the annual appeal, which supports all of the services and ministries of the diocese. And so whether it's Catholic social services, whether it's vocations, like I say, Andrew is in the seminary. I didn't pay for my education. It was paid through the diocese. And so these funds support all of those things. The retirement home for the priest at St. Joseph's Villa, Catholic social services. Here in Wilkes-Barre, we have St. Vincent de Paul soup kitchen, as well as homes for the homeless, and so forth and so on. Hispanic ministry is becoming St. Nick's over there. It takes care of the Hispanic ministry. And so the appeal also supports Hispanic ministry, which is growing in the diocese throughout various counties. Monroe County, down in Hazleton, here in Wilkes-Barre, and so forth. Catholic education is another big one, you know, to support our Catholic schools. Those of you who went and parents who sent your children so forth, or percentage goals as well to academic education. So Bishop Bambara speaks to us through this avenue of the video, but you know what happens every year anyway, so there's no sense of going through it and so forth. I know that you'll support, as you have in the past, the end, whatever you can do. It's hard this year as well, inflation and everything else. Fully understand everything that's going on. You know, so do your part, whatever you can do to make the annual appeal this year work. And Bishop Bambara, maybe a lot of you have already given to the annual appeal. If not, there are things in the pews or your letters in the mail that they send in as well. So thank you. You probably enjoyed hearing me. That would be more than me. But anyway, thank you very much, whatever you can do, okay? Let us stand for the creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate through the Virgin Mary. Amen. For our sins, Christ died and was crucified. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. Last line of the Gospel, Jesus said, will he find any faith on the earth? We are people of faith who believe in the power of prayer. Let us now place our needs.
For the church, that we may pray without becoming weary and support each other, so that we remain steady in our pursuit of justice and holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For judges, attorneys, and all who work in the justice system, that they may be persistent in pursuing justice and applying mercy. Let us pray to the work.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to violence and the threat of violence in our neighborhoods and in our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special intention book near the cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as Paul asked of Timothy, we may look to Scripture for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that we may be equipped for every good work. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are undergoing a crisis in their faith or a time of doubt, that the collective witness we give to our faith may sustain them and reassure them despite doubt or despair. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the life of every human person, from conception to natural death, might be protected in our laws and cherished in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in Christ, for Jerry McCurdy, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for others we would like to remember, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We ask that you watch over us in our struggles and listen to our prayers through Christ, brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our spirits, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the gospel of the Church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, all the clergy, religious, and faithful people. Remember Jerry McGrory, also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
You take away your sin.
benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepare for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go.